Whenever the Word of God is preached, you got to always remember that there's a need. Amen. There's a need all the time at this church. Amen. In your life, my life, and everyone's life. And that's what the Word of God is for, is to meet the need, to train us, to teach us, to equip us, to get us prepared, and get us ready for battle. Amen. It says, the Word of the Lord came to Jonah. You know, the God we serve is so real. He speaks to us and instructs us in different ways of what he wants us to do and how we serve him. Mm-hmm. Yesterday there was a great door of opportunity that opened up. They called me from the Chowchilla prison. Mm-hmm. And, the women's prison, they requested for me to come up and preach. And so I made it all. I mean, it was so hectic too, the military. But we had all kinds of things going. There was a lot of trouble at the automotive shop. And it was just hard for me to leave and get away because so many things going on. And there's a lot of pressure on me. But God spoke to me and delivered all of it. He said, just leave all this stuff alone. He said, don't worry about it. He said, you go.
Amen.
And I'm glad that I understood God real clear.
Amen.
Yesterday. So I was able to go up there. There was about probably 60, 75 women in a room about this size that I spoke to. And I'm telling you, there was the greatest revival that I ever seen in the women's lives. Mm. And all I shared, what went on in my life, and how God brought me out of it, and brought me where he's at now.
Amen.
Where I'm at now.
Amen.
There was one woman that I was sitting down talking to, and she told me, she said, she's been locked up for 25 years. Mm. And she's in the choir there, at the, of course, in prison with the women. She's in the choir, she's the leader. She said, Brother Lewis, she said, I've been locked up for 25 years, and I'm getting ready to get out. And I told her, I said, look, for 25 years, God has set you up under the anointing, and he's taken, and he's poured out into your life.
Uh-huh.
And then for 25 years, he's poured out into your life, and he's prepared you. And he's made you like a whale that's going to go out and you're going to have like a faucet to turn on. And all that that God has put into your life, and God's going to let it out and flow into other people's lives.
Amen.
You are going to be like a witness. You're going to be a testimony, a preacher of all preachers, one that God's going to use everywhere you go.
Amen.
I said, that's what it's all about.
Amen.
So don't make no difference about what happened in your life before. Mm-hmm. God has forgiven you that.
Amen.
I said, this is what makes a difference, what's happening right now. What are you going to do with your life right now?
Yes.
And come to find out, most of those women that in that prison, that section where I know I was at, most of them are lifers. They're doing life. Mm-hmm. They're never going to get out. And I was able to bring an encouraging word of heaven, our future, what's going to happen, when God comes to wrap this all up. You know, the Bible tells us that Jesus is going to come and he's going to take us all home. Mm-hmm. And I shared the truth with them that one day that they're going to be going home. And right now, God is pouring out into Christianity everywhere so we can partner other people.
Amen.
Amen.
We had a great, great time. I tell you,
amen.
I feel so much at home at that prison. I didn't know these. Those women, they were so loving and kind and receiving. I don't think it was a woman in that whole building that wasn't receiving. They were just all on the edge of their seats and just listening.
Amen.
And I was having a good time. The anointing of God fell all over me and I came unglued.
Amen.
And we had a good time for about an hour.
Amen. And
they want me to come back too on a Sunday morning. I told them I would.
Amen.
But, God is pouring out into all of us. And he's preparing us. assignment yesterday because I've been standing still, because I've been in the house of God, and I've been up under God's instruction. There was an assignment, very important assignment that came up, and I was able to go and carry out that assignment.
Amen.
That's going to happen to each and every one of you.
Amen.
There's going to be a time when God's going to say, now, you go over here, and I want you to do this, and you go over there, and I want you to do that.
Amen.
And, you know, and that's the situation with Jonah. Now, if you look at the title of this, the title it says, don't get caught in the belly of the fish.
Uh-huh.
And you understand, some of you that are not familiar with the story of Jonah, you'll understand by the time we're done why it's titled, don't get caught in the belly of the fish.
Amen.
You know, the scripture says that, well, for one thing, Jonah was rebellious. God had told him to go to Nineveh and preach to the Ninevites. Mm-hmm. God was about to destroy this whole city. But Jonah was mad at these Ninevites. He hated them. They were evil people. Mm-hmm. They did a lot of evil things to people. And so Jonah really didn't want to see them spared. He wanted to see them destroyed. So he decides, you know, he's going to go a different way than the way what God told him.
Wow.
That was the wrong thing to do.
Amen.
Wrong thing to do. He tried to get away from the presence of God.
Mm-hmm.
But the Bible says, it says, now the word of the Lord came unto Jonah, and they're saying, arise and go to Nineveh, that great city, and cry against it, for its wickedness has come up before me. Now, the Word of God comes to all of us in different ways. You know, God has a way of speaking to each and every one of us. And that's why it's so important that we be sensitive to the voice of God.
Amen.
And sometimes God, I don't know exactly how God spoke to Jonah. It was probably audible. There's men in the Old Testament, God spoke to a lot of them. Or it may have been that still small voice like what we get on the inside.
Yeah.
Is it hot in here for someone? Is not?
Yeah.
Can you turn it up a little bit? I feel a little warm. But see, God has a way of speaking to all of us. And that's why, again, we have to be real sensitive to the voice of God.
Amen.
It's always good when you pray, mm-hmm. and when you're down there praying and talking to God.
Yes.
Just kind of sit still.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of sit still. And just wait for God to speak to you.
Amen.
And He will.
Amen.
You know, because God has a way of speaking to us. And sometimes we're not aware of how God is speaking.
Amen.
Sometimes when God is speaking to some of us, sometimes we're not, because we're not aware of the voice of God.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes it goes, kind of goes over our head.
Uh-huh.
And we don't hear what God is saying because we haven't grown spiritually to be aware of when God is saying something. That's why it's always good practice. When you're praying, just sit still.
Amen.
After you pray, just sit still and wait for God to say something.
Amen.
Because see, when you're praying, it's communication.
Amen.
You see, and sometimes we just kind of make it one-sided. Mm-hmm. Where we're saying, God this, God that, God that, and we never wait to hear what God is saying.
Amen.
He wants to talk to us too, just like we're talking to Him.
Amen.
So we have to kind of be still. It's a good practice to be still.
Amen.
You know, because sometimes we haven't, some of us, some we haven't grown spiritually to know when God is saying something. If you remember when we taught on Eli and Samuel, when little Samuel, we heard the voice.
Uh-huh.
He'd get up in the middle of the night and he would say, he'd run to Eli and say, "You called me." He did it three times. And all the time it was God calling. Mm-hmm. He hadn't grown spiritually. The little boy hadn't grown spiritually to know the voice of God.
Amen.
And that's the way it is with us at times, you know, as we're going through our walk with God.
Uh-huh.
And then there's times too when we don't hear God because we're going through trials, we're going through persecution and troubles, and all those troubles and trials got our whole focus, you know. And God is over there wanting to say something to us, and because we're going through all these storms and all these problems, you know, our focus is on those storms and problems, and we can't think right, and can't see and hear the voice of God when He's saying something to us. And another could be because we're so preoccupied doing a bunch of things in life, and those things have got us preoccupied and got our full attention to where we can't hear God when He's speaking. And you know, Paul told Timothy this. He said, no man that's in a war entangle himself with this life affair so that he might please him who called him to be a soldier. Mm-hmm. What Paul was telling Timothy, he was saying that, you know, because you're in warfare and we're in warfare,
uh-huh.
He said, don't get tangled up with a lot of things in life.
Amen.
You see, don't get tangled up with so many things that you can't hear what God is saying.
Amen.
And people do that.
Uh-huh.
They got a time when they watching the TV and spend a lot of time on TV, and they got a time when they're going shopping, or got a time when they're going to this party and that party, and just things.
Uh-huh.
And in the midst of all those things, you know, you can't hear God. You know, because you're not really focusing on.
Amen.
So that's sometimes people folks have a hard time hearing God because they're preoccupied with so many things in life. They can't hear God because they've got all these other things going on in life.
Amen.
And then another could be because of like Jonah. Well, Jonah just. He heard God, but Jonah didn't want to hear God.
Uh-huh.
He heard God, but Jonah decided he was going to do it his way and not listen to God.
Amen.
And that was the wrong thing to do. Bad thing to do right there.
Amen.
And so I'm saying this. I'm saying that God speaks to all of us.
Amen.
God has assignments for all of us.
Amen.
And there's things that God wants each and every one of us to do.
Amen.
And so we have to get ourselves to the place where we hear God.
Amen.
Because there's one day God's going to just let you know point blank. Mm-hmm. And you won't be able to get out of it.
Amen.
You know, Jonah knew exactly what to do.
Uh-huh.
There's some people that kind of know what to do and they kind of ignore God.
Mm-hmm.
Or procrastinate. That's me right there. Sometimes I procrastinate.
Amen.
Yesterday I almost fell into procrastination.
Uh-huh.
But then I heard the word of God, I heard the voice of God saying, you go down to Chowchilla and speak to those women.
Amen.
And I'm glad I went. I thank God when I left out of prison yesterday.
Amen.
I was so grateful to you that God, that you got my attention, that I heard you.
Amen.
And I went and did what you said, what you told me to do.
Amen.
Because I'm going to tell you, if I wouldn't have went yesterday, I would have been in some kind of fish's belly.
Amen.
I already know.
Amen.
You see. And that's why it's titled, Stay Out of the Fish's Belly.
Uh-huh.
There's things that God wants us to do. There's things that God has called us to do.
Uh-huh.
There's people that God wants us to minister to.
Amen.
You see, Jonah was supposed to go to Nineveh.
Uh-huh.
This whole city. Whole city of people was about to be destroyed. Whole complete city.
Uh-huh.
And God was used Jonah to get these people to repent.
Amen.
Well, see, we each and every one of us got Nineveh all around us every day.
Amen.
Might be someone in your own home, might be your neighbor. Amen.
Amen.
Might be your friend that's down the street, or somebody at the school, you know, or somebody at the work, you know. You know, there's a Nineveh all over. People that's on the verge of being destroyed. People that's on the verge of going into eternity, stepping into eternity. And it could be hell's fire. And God is sitting you here in this church, and again, He's pouring out into you and me, and what He's pouring out into us, He expects us one day to, you know, to get up and use it. Amen.
Amen.
Get out there and find those Ninevehs and work with those Ninevehs and preach the gospel and share with them the good news about Jesus. And so folks, we got to get to the place where we hear God.
Amen.
That's what first starts. It starts with you and I hearing God. Amen. If we don't never hear God, we won't never know what God wants us to do.
Amen.
Says the word of God came to Jonah. Amen. God came to him. The word of God came and told him, Jonah, arise and go to Nineveh. And go to Nineveh and preach in that great city. He said, and cry against it. He said, because that wickedness and evil has come up before me. God told Jonah, he said, go over. He said, and cry. That word crying, it means that there was something evil, something very, very evil that was about to come upon these people. Something really, really, something God was concerned about. Because it was about to take all these people's lives. This whole city was about to be destroyed. And there was all the children, the people, families, animals, everybody in the whole city was about to die.
Amen.
Now, if that ain't nothing to be concerned about, I don't know what is.
Come on, preacher.
God told Jonah, he said, he didn't tell him to go preach. He said, go cry.
That's right.
Amen. He said, let her cry out. He said, let these people know your feeling. He said, let them know your feeling. He said, make them feel what you feel.
Amen.
Let them know that this is urgent. This is important. This ain't nothing to put aside. Ain't nothing to just to talk about or think about, but it's something about concerning your life.
Amen.
When God sends us a people, it's about their life.
Amen.
The things and you see, God told him, he said, go cry against it. He said, because their wickedness has come up before me.
Uh-huh.
You see, what's killing folk these days and what's got people on the road to hell and uh-huh. got their family all messed up and everything happens
right.
is sin. Amen. If you look behind the scene, you'll
Amen.
See that yeah. three-letter word, S-I-N,
Come on.
Is in that family, is in that father's life, that mother's life, those children's life.
Amen. Say it.
The Bible says, for the wages of sin is death.
Amen. Uh-huh. Come on.
And people are working hard for an awful payday today.
Amen.
God told Jonah, he said, go and cry. He said, let out a cry. He said, make these people feel how serious it is.
Amen.
Let them feel how serious it is. He said, their wickedness is coming before me.
Uh-huh.
See, one thing about God judges sin.
Amen.
Sin and wickedness, God judges.
Amen.
God don't turn his head. He don't look past it.
Yeah.
He don't look over it.
Mm-hmm.
And he don't look beyond it.
Amen.
Scripture said, for the wages of sin is death. God judges sin.
Amen.
And he deals with it. And when God pardons sin, it's because somebody is repenting.
Amen.
You see, and so if there's no repentance, well, then there's judgment on the way.
Amen.
That's what was going on with Nineveh.
Mm-hmm.
God told Jonah, he said, go preach to them.
Uh-huh.
Go cry to them. Tell them their wickedness is coming before me. It was time for judgment for Nineveh.
Uh-huh.
Jonah was their ticket out. Some of you are Jonah.
Uh-huh.
God has called you. He put you in this church. Put you up under the word of God.
Amen.
To fill you up.
Amen.
So that you can pour out in other people's lives.
Amen.
But the thing with Jonah, God told him to go cry against it. He said, for the wickedness has come up before me. Then the Bible says that Jonah rose up to flee under Tarshish. From the presence of the Lord, went down to Joppa. He found a ship going to Tarshish. So he paid the fare thereof and went down into it to go with him to Tarshish. And look what the scripture says, from the presence of the Lord. Mm-hmm. That this is the most foolish way to live that there is.
Amen.
I can't understand Jonah being the man that he is. You see, God wouldn't have gave Jonah this assignment
uh-huh.
unless Jonah had an ample time to spend with God and to know God.
Amen.
He wouldn't have gave him this assignment. God was not going to give assignments to people that don't have some kind of background.
Amen.
Somebody that hadn't been sitting down. You see, you can expect very little from a man or woman that ain't interested in God. You can expect very little for God to use him.
Amen.
You know, God's not going to too much use people like that because they ain't even interested in the things of God.
Amen.
You know, God can give them things and they're just going to let it sit there. They ain't going to do nothing with it.
Uh-huh.
You see, and the things of God, the important things got to be done with it.
Amen.
So Jonah had some kind of background of being with God.
Amen.
For him to react like this foolishly, to think that he's going to get out of the presence of God, I want to tell you, this is a very, very foolish man to think something like that. Amen. If you read Psalm 39, you'll see that wherever we go, God is with us. Amen.
Amen.
You'll see we can't escape the presence of God. You can't get away from God. You can't hide from him. You can't run from him. You try to run, he's going to catch you. He got faster tennis shoes than you got. Amen. Hallelujah. You know, we just try to run from the police and they just get on the radio and they catch us down the street. Amen. See, that's the way it is with God. They get on the radio. You caught the Holy Ghost on the north, east, west, and south side. Catch him on that corner, Holy Ghost. You try to run, trying to get away from him. Catch him, catch him.
Hallelujah.
A foolish person is trying to run from God.
Amen.
I want to tell you something. If we get this straight in our life, we gain a great deal with God.
Amen.
When we know that it ain't no running, when we know it ain't no hiding from God.
Amen.
You can't get away with nothing, neither can I.
Come on now.
Whatever we do in secret, God sees it.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. You try to do this. Whatever's in the darkness, he said, going to be brought to the light.
Hallelujah.
You can't tell a little white lie. You can't look at something the wrong way. You can't talk the wrong stuff. You can't do nothing. Neither can I. God knows about it. You can't flee from the presence of God. Yeah, this man was foolish. Very, very foolish, but just stay trying to get away from God, running from God. God don't think he's going to get on another boat and going to go get away from God. How in the world can we do that? There's no way. There's no way. You know, the only way out with God, just keep him up in there. Keep submitted.
Amen.
Tell him, yes, master, I'm ready. Here I am.
Amen.
That's right.
Amen.
You don't try that funny business with God because it's not going to work.
Amen.
But Jonah found that out.
Amen.
That's why I can't figure out what the world's wrong with Jonah.
Uh-huh.
And you know God. He knows this is God's character. You can't deal with God like that.
Amen.
One thing we can do with God is just submit.
Amen.
Amen. Just submit. Amen. Be responsible and do what he asks us to do.
Amen.
So it says Jonah got on another boat.
Uh-huh.
Oh boy.
Mm.
Says he got on another boat. But the Lord, in verse 4, sent a great wind in the sea. And there was a mighty tempest in the sea. So the ship was like to be broken. And the mariners, they was afraid. Everybody started crying to their God. You see, this is typical of all kind of foreign gods. People depending on other gods to deliver them. America's main god is the dollar bill.
Woo.
But you know, but see, this situation that arrives, there ain't no deliverance gonna come no other way but from the God of Israel.
Amen.
So they got all these mariners. It was in this big storm. And the storm came upon them because Jonah was in the boat.
Uh-huh.
You better be careful who you ride in your car.
Come on now.
I'm telling you. You better be careful.
Amen.
See, there's times, I mean, you can be around people that's cursed.
Uh-huh.
And guess what's going to happen?
Come on.
That same storm is going to fall upon them and might get you too.
Come on, Father.
I'm telling you, I'm being serious.
Amen.
You better be careful who you associate with, who you're next to, who you're running with, who you're talking to and having fellowship with. Better be very, very careful. So you never know, you know, what's going on in the people's life. So Jonah trying to run from God, he got on the boat with these people. And now because Jonah's on there, this whole boat is in the middle of the storm. The boat is about to be broken in two, about to crack in two. They're in the middle of the sea, and they're about to all drown out there. And they begin to cry and holler and begin to call upon the God of Zoo, the God of Jew, the God of Tula, whatever God it was.
Come on, preacher.
They were looking for any kind of God, amen, to get us out of this mess, amen. That's what they were doing.
Amen.
Yeah, they were just calling on anything that might help them.
Amen.
They were calling on.
Uh-huh.
And so they cast lots. You see, these people believed in and all kind of black magic and different things like that. And so they used those things. That was typical for them. So they cast lots to see where the trouble was coming from, who it was that was bringing the trouble. So the lot fell on Jonah. You know, Jonah wasn't about to say nothing. No, Jonah was, he was down in the bottom of the ship sleeping. You know, because he knew what Jonah knew all the time, what was going on. But Jonah wasn't about to say nothing. He was trying to keep quiet.
Amen.
Make it seem like it was Harry or Henry or somebody.
Come on,
somebody's fault.
Amen.
Amen.
Come
and
on.
That's the way we do it.
Amen.
Amen.
And so they found out it was Jonah, and then they asked Jonah, they said, who are you? And where you come from? And what's your occupation? And where you going? And so now, you know, the Jonah's in the hot seat. And,
uh-huh.
And so Jonah has to reveal some things. He said, I'm a Hebrew, and
uh-huh.
I fear the God of heaven. And amen. He told him about what's going on and this and that and all that he's going through with God. And so now, you know, they got to make a decision what to do. And so they asked Jonah, what should they do? To him, to, you know, to spare their life. And Jonah told him, and he said, throw me overboard,
uh-huh.
Yeah. And you'll be taken out of this a big storm.
Amen.
But I want you to look at this with me here. Jonah said, I'm in the middle of verse, looks like it's 12. He said unto them, take me up and cast me forth into the sea, and so shall the sea be calm for you.
Uh-huh.
He said, for I know for my sake this great tempest has come upon you.
Yes.
See, Jonah knew all the time.
Uh-huh.
He knew what was going on.
Come on now.
And there's times when we,
yes, come on, say it.
When we're doing things we ain't supposed to be doing.
Yeah.
There's times when judgment begins to come upon us. There's times when God sends like a storm in our life.
Amen.
And we know that we're not ignorant of the fact, of the true fact.
Amen.
That it's God and it's coming from God.
Amen.
I know when God is dealing with me because of my disobedience.
Amen.
I know when God is saying something to me.
Amen.
And I know it's something in my life. Amen. So Jonah says, I know that all this tempest has come upon you because of me.
Amen.
He knows. God has revealed that to him.
Mm-hmm.
And usually when we disobedient,
yes,
and when we're going the wrong way,
come on now,
we're not following God correctly.
Amen.
Usually the Holy Spirit is there,
yeah,
revealing to us. Amen.
Amen.
And we know, yeah, we're not in the right place with God. We know,
amen,
we're not doing right. We know
we're
wrong.
Amen.
And I'm going to tell you something, folks, when that Spirit of God comes and begin to reveal to you, that you know that that's the time right then,
yes,
to just to begin to get it right with God.
Amen.
That's the time right then. You know, you'll see what Jonah, he got in the fish's belly and he started praying.
Yes,
and
yes,
he started praying and he started talking to God and he started repenting and telling God, I'm sorry. You know, but perhaps Jonah wouldn't have had to go in the fish's belly.
Yeah.
Perhaps he wouldn't have had to even go into the sea.
Amen.
Perhaps right then when he says, I know. Perhaps right then, if you
Perhaps you just said, God, I'm ready to go right now. I repent. I'm changing my mind.
Yes.
Perhaps he wouldn't have to make it down to the fish, to the belly of the fish.
Amen.
This is just a thought.
Amen.
This is just a thought. I don't know. Mm-hmm. Maybe, but maybe not. Mm-hmm. See, we know God is real kind. God is a forgiving God.
Yes,
and there's times when God, he'll repent of wicked evil what he's going to bring upon us.
Uh-huh.
We'll even see that toward the end.
Amen.
But Jonah got down the belly of the fish and then he started praying.
Uh-huh.
And it's just a thought, maybe if he would have prayed right then.
Come on now.
Maybe if he would have prayed right then, just maybe. He already knew.
Mm-hmm.
He knew that God was dealing with him.
Amen.
He knew that all these men on this ship, lives was in trouble because of him.
Amen.
Maybe if he would have just right then, if he would have begun to pray and talk to God, maybe God would have turned the whole situation around.
Amen.
That's right.
Sometimes we wait until a judgment falls.
Amen.
Sometimes we wait until the worst of the situation before Amen. We go to tell him, God, I'm sorry.
Amen.
Why not do it right now before the roof falls in? Why don't we pray and ask God? Amen.
Amen.
Keep the roof up before it falls in.
Amen.
Why don't we wait until the roof falls in?
Amen. Come on now.
It's just a thought.
Uh-huh.
It's just a thought.
Amen.
But the Bible says that Jonah said, I know that for my sake, this great tempest is upon you. In verse 13, we got this new hymn now. In verse 13, listen. Scripture says, nevertheless, the men rode hard and raised this man, but they could not. For the sea lost and was tempted to make them. You see, a Jonah, and they're quiet. And he knows how powerful God is.
Amen.
Listen, folks. Let never be foolish like Jonah.
Amen.
Did these men here come a little out of the storm
uh-huh.
that God didn't place
uh-huh.
right in their life?
Uh-huh.
So, tell you something. When God is doing something,
come on now.
When God allows a storm,
uh-huh.
when God allows something to get you on the right track,
come on now.
You ain't going to get out of it until you get out of the right track.
Amen.
They could have rode all night.
Uh-huh.
If they would have had a 7.7 engine on the boat, they still wouldn't have got out of this storm.
Amen.
They wouldn't have got out of this storm.
Amen.
When God initiates the storm,
uh-huh.
the only way out is to look up.
Come on now, hallelujah.
That's all the way out.
Right.
Amen.
And these men were trying to row out of it. They would have never got out of it. You and I will never get out of it.
Amen.
Especially for disobedience.
Amen.
Sometimes we initiate those storms in our own minds.
Amen. Say that.
Because we're disobedient.
Amen.
And the only way to get out of those storms
Amen.
Is not to try to roll your way out, but try to look up and get out.
Amen.
And God makes a way out.
Amen.
So they rolled and rolled and rolled.
Amen.
Couldn't get nowhere.
Yes.
And I'm just thinking, why old Jonah didn't have enough sense to tell these men, mm-hmm. this is not going to work.
Amen.
Mm-hmm. He was over.
Yeah, he was over.
Uh-huh.
He was over. Mm-hmm. He was probably start praying right uh-huh. then.
Amen.
He would have saved himself a lot of trouble.
Amen.
And he was hoping these men were going to get him out there. He should have known better than that.
Amen.
We should know better than that, too.
Amen.
That God is our only way out.
Amen.
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 So, the Bible says that they rode and rode.
trying to figure it out, it wasn't going to work.
Amen.
So they took Jonah mm-hmm. and cast him in the sea.
Uh-huh.
And the Bible says that the Lord prepared mm-hmm. the great fish. Mm-hmm. Now, looking at verse 17, mm-hmm. it says, first look with me in verse 4. It says, but the Lord sent out a great wind into the sea.
Uh-huh.
Verse 17, now the Lord has prepared a great fish uh-huh. for the them.
Uh-huh.
Sometimes don't blame on the devil.
Amen.
All right.
Amen.
But I'm telling you right now, sometimes don't blame on the devil.
Amen.
If you're disobedient, don't even try to put it on the devil.
Amen. That's still.
When the whirlwind comes into your life.
Come on, preacher.
Do not try to put it on the devil.
Teach, preacher.
It said the Lord was the one that orchestrated this big storm.
Yes,
it said the Lord was the one that prepared Moby Dick to swallow Father of Jonah.
Amen.
That God did that.
Amen.
And that's what I'm saying. Disobedience.
Uh-huh.
Disobedience
mm-hmm.
will bring trouble in our own life like that.
Amen.
So the fish swallowed Jonah. And the scripture said the word of the Lord came unto Jonah the second time. Look at that. Look at verse 3 with up at the top of the right hand corner. The word of the Lord came unto Jonah the second time, saying, arise and go to Nineveh. God is the God of second chance.
Amen.
You hear what I'm saying?
Amen.
God is the God of second chance.
Amen.
Jonah had a second chance to arise and go to Nineveh.
Amen.
After all this, he went through with God.
Uh-huh.
You know, trying to flee from his presence. After all of Jonah's craftiness and trying to do things his way.
Uh-huh.
Isn't that like us? Don't we try to do stuff our way?
Amen.
Don't we try to work it out without
Amen.
God and try
Amen.
To work around God,
Amen.
Work against God?
Amen.
And then we find out we should just did what God told us to do. And God is always there with his arms open wide.
Amen.
After we went through all of our mess,
Amen.
Went through all of our stuff, he's still there with his arms open wide
Amen.
To give us a second chance. Isn't he a good God? Amen.
Amen.
So the word of the Lord came to Jonah the second time, saying, arise and go to Nineveh.
Uh-huh.
You know, this was after Jonah had stayed in the belly of fish 3 days and three nights. And of course, Jonah got in the belly of the fish and then he started praying.
Uh-huh.
And that's what I'm saying. You
Come
know,
down. Yes.
You see down here in verse 2 that Jonah was praying. I mean, chapter 2 that Jonah was praying.
Uh-huh.
But he should have been praying
Come on.
When he was on that boat.
Amen.
When he was in down there sleeping.
Uh-huh.
And trying to make like it wasn't nothing going on.
Uh-huh.
Maybe he should have been praying right then.
Amen.
I don't believe Jonah repented until they busted him.
Amen.
I don't
Amen.
Believe it until they busted him, and then he wanted to, you know, humble himself and talk
uh-huh,
about it.
Uh-huh.
Kind of like Cain.
Uh-huh.
You know, kind of like the way the attitude Cain had.
Mm-hmm.
You know, God come to him and told him, you know, all you have to do is repent and be good and do right. And
uh-huh.
he said, and you'll save yourself a lot of judgment.
Uh-huh.
Well, I just believe uh-huh. that probably if Jonah was when he was up there in the hull of the boat and asleep, I believe he had been praying and talking to God sincerely.
Uh-huh.
I believe if God would have had that fish go another way, would have took that wind away,
Amen.
Would have calmed that boat down,
Amen.
And told him to send that boat back to Nineveh,
Amen.
To drop Jonah off.
Amen.
I believe that that's the God we serve. Amen.
Amen.
So the word of God came to Jonah the second time and told him, go again. Amen.
Amen.
And sometimes God has to come to us a second time, sometimes
Amen.
The third time.
Amen.
Tell us over and over and over and over until we get it right.
Amen.
Go over there and do what I told you to do.
Amen.
Go over to that church. Go over there.
Amen.
Sit in that Bible study. Go
Amen.
Over there and talk to them people. Go and do this and do that.
Amen.
You know, and God is like that. He's a God of a second chance.
Amen.
But see, we have to be a people of understanding, too.
Amen.
And realizing how real God is.
Amen.
You know, I think it took Jonah all this time to get to this place.
Uh-huh.
To really understand that he can't get away from God. He can't run from God.
Amen.
You know, it's not, what God told him is not going to disappear.
Amen.
What God told us is not going to disappear.
Amen.
You know, we don't have to face it. We going to have to deal with whatever it is God told us. We ain't going to be able to run and hide and get away from it.
Amen.
So the only way out is just to face it and be obedient to God.
Amen.
So when Jonah listens to God, mm-hmm. and he goes to Nineveh, and he cries like God told him, said, go cry to these people.
Amen.
He told him, he said, in 3 days, he said, Nineveh's going to be overturned. And the Bible says in the 3rd chapter, the 5th verse, so the people of Nineveh believed God and proclaimed the fast.
Uh-huh.
Put on sackcloth and gave it to them, and he doesn't believe. And God saw the work that they turned from their evil way, and God repented of the evil that he had said that he would do unto them. And he did it not.
Uh-huh.
See, that's the result of obedience to God.
Amen.
This is the result here of living in, of being poured out into, mm-hmm. and then allowing God to pour you out into other people's lives.
Amen.
This is the result. People's lives are saved.
Amen.
People's lives are turned around and changed.
Amen.
Oh, Jonah, we see in the story that Jonah, you know, as he preached to him, he went and sat outside the city mm-hmm. to see if God was going to overturn the city. Mm-hmm. God put a little gourd on it to shade him. And Jonah got mad when that gourd was taken away. And so God explained to him about he cared so much for the gourd. Mm-hmm. But Jonah didn't have a lot of care. There were over 600,000 people, God said, in that city that didn't know the right hand from the left.
Amen.
In other words, these people were completely blind. They were unaware that death was about to come upon them.
Amen.
They didn't know that their wickedness was about to cause them to be overthrown.
Amen.
They didn't know that sin. See, people think that sin is normal because the whole world is wrapped up in it.
Uh-huh.
It's all on the TV, on the internet, everywhere you go, at school, at work. People think it's just a normal way to live.
Uh-huh.
And they don't know.
Uh-huh.
And so these people in Nineveh, that's the way they were. They didn't realize the wickedness was about to take
right.
him out.
That's right, that's right.
God told Jonah, you know, when Jonah was going through all this stuff about this gold,
mm-hmm.
God told him, you cared a lot about this gold, but there was over 600,000 people in this city didn't know the right hand from the left. He said, should not spare them. Should not have concern about them.
Amen.
And see, this gives us something real good to understand and listen to.
Uh-huh.
You're talking about a whole world of people out there. Sometimes we're not concerned about them.
Amen.
Jonah wasn't concerned about him because he hated him. He wanted to see him destroyed.
Uh-huh.
Sometimes we can take on that attitude also. When
Amen.
We hate someone,
Amen.
And we don't, you know, we want much more to see him dead than alive. We can take that attitude up.
Amen.
But I want you to know today that God wants us to have a different attitude
Amen.
Toward people.
Amen.
God wants us to be concerned about the lost and about
Amen.
Those people. That's about to fry in the frying pan forever.
Amen.
About to make it into the flames of hell. Those people
Amen.
Are being destroyed and hurt and going through miserable things. God wants us to be concerned about
right.
these things instead of concerned about things about for ourselves and other
Amen.
Things all the time. We have to take great concern for people. I thank God that yesterday that I left everything alone and pushed everything aside regardless of what could happen
Amen.
And took that trip over to Corcoran Prison
Amen.
And preached to those women.
Amen.
I thank God I did that.
Amen.
So there's times where God is calling us all to go places and do this and do that.
Uh-huh.
And we're concerned about other things too much.
Amen.
Instead of being concerned about what's reality
Amen.
About people's lives.
Amen.
He told me 600,000 people that don't know the right hand from the left. That's the way it is in this city we live in.
Amen.
There's just thousands of people that are blind, they're naked, they can't see where they're going, they're lame. They don't understand nothing.
Amen.
They don't see sin as a killer.
No.
They don't see sin as deadly.
Amen.
And spiritually, they have to be spoken to.
Amen.
And you're the one that's got the message.
Amen.
Because God has sent you here and he's explained it to you.
Amen.
He's revealed to you the truth.
Amen.
And he's put something in you to
Amen.
Take to the world.
Amen.
Could you bow with me? Father, we thank you for the truth. And God, I pray every day, I pray for terrible to be so stupid and foolish to try to run from your presence. Teach us, God, how to pray before the roof falls in. Teach us, God, how to be obedient, God, so we'll stay out of the belly of the fish, God. Teach us, God, what's most important of all, to have concern, God, about the lost state of the world that we live in, and the people, God, that's about to die. Show us, God, who our Nineveh is, God. Lord, that we can go to that Nineveh and see help we brought to that Nineveh. I pray for all these people here, and number one myself, God, that I will never lose sight of these things. God, we thank you for your good, kind, loving hand.